done some damage on this day over the last few years. Leads the Minnesota Wild with 7 points on Hockey Day Minnesota.
And we're underway from downtown St. Paul. Stahl, Zuccarello, Parisi to open for Minnesota. He gloves it, drops it, plays it back into his own zone. Lindell has it there. Both teams change as we're just about a minute in here in St. Paul. Janmark plays to the wing for Radulov. Radulov, a long shot and a blocker saved by Stalock. Stars control here with Dickinson, plays it up the boards. A heavy hit by Foligno behind the play, and then another by Cunnan. Eriksson Ek leaves it for Foligno. These teams have split two meetings so far this year. Dallas came from 3 goals down to win the first meeting in Dallas 6-3. Wild won in a shootout, 3-2 here in St. Paul. Donato fires from long range, and a save made by Hudobin, who hangs on.
Pretty for the Minnesota Wild, so they're going to have to stay out of the box. They only took 2 penalties last game against the Tampa Bay Lightning. That's going to have to be part of the recipe if they want to win here tonight.
Spurgeon throws one toward the net. Hudobin got a piece of it. Pollock holds with the skate, quickly across for Suter. Into the middle, Parisi. Back to Suter moving in. Into the slot, Zuccarello. His shot, then Parisi's. Both stopped by Hudobin. And great success as a member of the UMD Bulldogs when they came down to play here. And then since signing with the Minnesota Wild, I mentioned this off the top, Eriksson Ek across to Fiala. Fiala cuts to the slot. Still with it, a shot saved by Hudobin. He just got the 5-hole closed in time. Fiala with 2 points against the Stars so far this season on a goal and an assist in the 2 head-to-head meetings. Sagan plays it to the line. A long shot tipped and saved by Stalock. Back to Greenway in the corner. He feeds the line and Dumba. Dumba fanned on it. Here's a chance for Gurianov on the breakaway. Gurianov in alone. Saved by Stalock. Gurianov, an exciting player. 12th overall pick by the Stars in 2015. Here comes Zuccarello for Minnesota. Spins away from Oleksiak. Back to Spurgeon. He scores!
Stretch pass by Ryan Suter. We've seen many, many of those over the years. He's played for the Minnesota Wild. Zuccarello pulls up, looking for a right-handed shot. He sees one coming in late. And the Dallas Star defenseman, Pollock, crosses right across the sight lines at the perfect time.
Stalock thought about coming out to play it. Pattern instead scoops it up for Minnesota. Off the boards to Foligno. Centers to Eriksson Ek. He fires, and a save by Hudobin. Hartman to Soucy. Soucy works down the wall, a shot tipped out front and just wide. Hartman ducks past Johnsberg. Shoved it ahead. Great stick by Spurgeon, knocks it away from Radulov. Oleksiak with a long shot, saved by Stalock, and he's able to cover. And additionally, they're so stingy. Number one in the league in goals against. They're 18-3-2 when they score first. Fiala chips it out to center, and Minnesota will change as Klingberg tries to regroup quickly, turn it over. Zucker has it. Donato driving the net. Zucker back to Soucy. He scores!
Neutral zone right there. He was at the end of a shift. He looked to me like he was going to make a change. Makes the right decision, gives it to the right player. Carson Soucy gets the puck right up over Jamie Benn's shin pad. 6 inches inside the left post and beats Hudobin on the blocker side. Gets it up a little higher than that.
Minnesota then beat him 5-2 in 2012 when Hockey Day was hosted by Minnetonka. And beat him in 2014 when Hockey Day was hosted by Elk River. And Elk River's own Nate Prosser scored the winner in overtime here in St. Paul to cap the night. Greenway back to Hartman, a shot and a save by Hudobin.
And one of the most positive people I've ever been around. Unbelievable teammate, played hard every night, and just even last night in the alumni game.
The line, Brodin settles a bouncing puck, got it to Fiala, pitched into the corner for Zucker. Zucker out front, a shot by Dumba, save Hudobin. Rebound to the corner, Zucker taps it to Fiala. Now to the line, Brodin. Brodin works to the middle, back to Fiala. Into the corner, Zucker, they score! It was deflected in out front by Sequeira. And Zucker will get the power play goal for Minnesota.
Like he was trying to throw that puck back door to the Wild player on the back door. Dallas Star defenseman gets his stick on the puck. We've seen that a few times happen against the Minnesota Wild, killing penalties. Ryan Suter a couple times over the last few games. Now the Minnesota Wild finally catch a break on the power play.
The power play tally has Minnesota in front by 3. Hintz carries down low. Stalock with a pad save. Greenway trying to catch up with a puck down to the Dallas zone, but Johns is the first man back. Hartman intercepts, watched by Janmark, got it through Donato, he scores!
A puck to his backhand again, we talked about Greenway getting in on the forecheck. Donato creates the loose puck, and then Ryan Hartman with just a nice little, soft little 15-foot pass to get the puck to inside ice with to Ryan Donato. And when Ryan Donato gets alone with the goalie, I mean, he's a finisher. This boy knows what he wants to do around the net. I know he's not the fastest guy in the world, but
rebound controlled by Hintz. Out to the line, Oleksiak, a long shot, covered by Stalock. And we get a whistle. And tonight, we had one of the two second period goals that came 33 seconds apart and allowed Minnesota to stretch a 2-0 lead into 4-0.
This is his 17th start of the season, and Ben Bishop's only started 31. Keeping these two guys fresh, they're both big goalies. They're both, you know, 6'3", 6'4". They're both 33 years old, so it's not like they're young goalies. So
ahead for Corey Perry. Perry works to the middle, drops it back, and Dickinson pushed it wide. He had an awful lot of empty net at which to shoot. Puck is loose. Stalock finally able to cut. Klingberg comes ahead for the Stars. Able to dump it into the zone. Knocked out of the air by Soucy. Sagan with a shot and a save by Stalock. Rebound controlled by Eriksson Ek. Foligno, one touch back to Patterson.
And this is the first time in about the last 7 or 8 minutes where the Minnesota Wild has had some extended offensive zone time. The Dallas Stars have spent a good chunk of the time.
Zucker a shot! Pad save! Zuccarello scores! And it's 5-0 Minnesota!
Doesn't miss the net. That's why it's very important. Always hit the net. You have a chance to score if you hit the net, but goalie does not have a chance to extend the rebound or get the rebound, and Matt Zuccarello.
Wild regroup. Here's a pass across, and Stahl hit the post. Parisi fires, and a save by Bishop. The offensive zone, he goes across for Parisi. Parisi sweeps it around behind the net. Suter holds. Suter fires, tip the score! Parisi tips it in for Minnesota!
Opportunity at the top to get the puck on the net. And we've got this guy right here that makes his living in around the National Hockey League, deflecting pucks just like that, just like Dino Cicerelli did. Your older players in the Minnesota Wild have that luxury here in the third period, and that could pay dividends here.
Here they score on the power play. Hartman hammering away out front. Donato and Greenway once again in the middle of things for Minnesota. Hartman with a power play tally makes it 7-0.
Zuccarello able to come up with a... Or Hartman able to come up with a loose puck. I think Jordan Greenway is going to pick up an assist on that. Good for him. That's his second assist of the night, and he's deserved a little bit of power play time. It's been the best game that he's played here in the last 5 or 6 games. So, Alex Stalock, Hockey Day Minnesota, South St. Paul native. What a great feeling for Alex Stalock.